Welcome back. We're us, and this is Enderal, Forgotten Stories. Now, I'm recording this the same day I'm recording the first video, so if anyone has happened upon the video and watched the whole way through and deigned to answer our question in the comments, I have not seen it yet. So keep that in mind as we go forward from now. This will be the last video I record today, and this should be going up Tuesday. So yeah, it'll just let me fall to my death. That's what I like about Skyrim. It lets you be dumb. Read your journal with J and open your hero menu with H. Alchemy allows you to brew health and mana potions and deadly poison. Alchemy is subject to the memories of Vagrant and the Lycanthrope. Cool beans. And I know I can meditate with Y, but there's no reason for that. Still can't sprint, which sucks. I haven't played a Skyrim. Well, I haven't played Skyrim. The Ruin. Just like in the Vision. I haven't played Skyrim in a while. Whoa, what the frick? I just... Wow. Those bastards are really hard to see. Your health is low. Eat something. That's right. I guess this is my inventory. They wouldn't even let me keep the clothes I stole. Terrible. Fever. You feel odd, cold, but at the same time feverish. It takes its toll from you to focus your thoughts. Okay. Breath of the Desert. Cultural bonus. Yeah, okay. And what exactly am I supposed to eat? That's not going to help. I'll take it, but it's not going to help. Give me something good to eat. Apples, that'll do. Wait. Wine bottle. There's the other rat. Really? Can't even make rat nuggets. Raising your skills with learning books. Take the book at the skeleton's feet and use it. use it or equip other items from your open your inventory with I. You okay, man? Said there's a book here. Learning book, one-handed apprentice. Well, I can't drink the water. If it's trash, I'll treat it as such and remove it from my inventory. But until it's proven to be the case, something up there is in need of a punching. Let's check out these mud morals while I'm thinking about it. Shock resistance. Okay. Restores mana. A little weird, but whatever. Hey, we've got some more health restore. So I can chug wheat if I can find it. Wait. Fog sponge. Well, we have to eat it to find out what it does. We've got blue that way, and more darkness that way, and that way. I don't know about you guys, but I'm a color man, so we'll come this way to see what's up. Certain areas, healing spells and health potions raise your arcane fever. Okay. What is arcane fever? Doesn't show its effect. Oh. That's unfortunate. Scroll of Boon heals you by 35 points of health, worsens your arcane fever by 2%. Spell Tome Grounding, lightning that does 7 points of shock damage and half as much of mana damage per second. So we've got two junked books. Chuck that wheat. Let's see. While in game, press Q to open the favorites menu, which allows you to quickly use or equip items you have marked as your favorites. Okay. We are become Magus. It's over here. This place is awful. Okay, so we came from this way because we turned left to go to the blue area. Weird. The spell is in my right hand, but I have to press left click to use it. I can't imagine this goes well if I take any of these. But watch me do it anyway. Okay. Scrap metal of an ancient nation. I mean, these two things could be used as a shield. This probably for crossbows, though. Lessens arcane fever. My question is whether or not arcane fever is something that doesn't just reduce itself over time. It's good we came this way. I'm just going to quick save because I can only imagine something is going to be barreling through there. Which is even worse since I can't sprint. to rest in Enderal, you need a sleeping place, hence you need to search for beds and visit taverns. Bone buddy. Bone buddy? Tell me your secrets. What have you seen here that reduced you to such a state? Inedible beer? Just going to try and get that out of my inventory. Increases stamina regeneration. Ta-da! Learning. Where did... See, I couldn't see this stuff. That was one of the beers dropping into the drink. Yeah, I can't see. Okay, so let's see what we've picked up. So we've got a learning book for elementalism. Yes, I don't have enough learning points. Just wanted to make sure. Just a few hours. I want to recoup my health. I left click and it puts it in the right hand. I right click and it puts it in the left hand. Okay. Good enough. The corpses and the light, they're gone. I know I'm doing a lot of meandering and searching every nook and cranny, but that's just what I do whenever that seems to be the best possible course of action. I mean, I would have walked right past those books if I hadn't. I'd have walked right past those books if I hadn't been screwing around with our bone buddy out there. I don't like that. So yes, keep in mind that I'm going to be doing a lot of wandering and I can hardly see here. This machine, why does it seem so familiar? Let me see if I can do something about the darkness. Okay, this looks terrible, but it makes things better for me. Oh, yeah, we definitely have to go down there then. So let's make sure we've seen everything that there is to see up here first. Rule number one of exploration. More like rule number one of open world games. You found an ice claw. Ice claws listed in your inventory under consumables permanently raise your carry weight by 1 point when eaten. Hey, look what we managed to pick up. I can't climb walls yet because I don't have a horse. Also keep in mind that I know that the crackling sound is rather obnoxious, but I also have no idea how to stow my weapons right now. These don't do anything I care about. They might be useful for alchemy, though, which is my thing, so better take them just in case. Oh, that's auto run. There we go. You look rather meaty. Yeah, I don't think I will. You just go ahead and keep that, buddy. What can we do with the pickaxe? Okay. That'll go on the right hand. I don't think we'll favorite that. If there was a bow near our bone buddy, I didn't see it. I could go back, but I won't. To admit, guys, being able to see is pretty freaking nice. A rancid mana potion and a spell tome. That's what happened. Oh. Oh. Oh, that's... Yeah, he'll mash my beans for certain. I've got a... an old, useless pickaxe, and some flimsy magic. That's a classic combination to get your beans mashed. Heals the caster for 6 points per second, worsens your arcane fever by 0.5%, worsening the fever can be lessened by the perk Mental Expert. Booyah. Okay, so I need to swap to magic. All the magic we know. Then we put this on favorites. Do this, do this. Right click. F. Select group. That's not the right one. Cool. So we have damage on one and healing on two. It does not work like I expected. Probably put away the crackling energy hands. Just gonna blueprint for an iron dagger, smoking pipe, and a toolbox. To smoke peasweed, activate a smoking pipe in your inventory. I think no. At least for right now. Ha! We're in danger. Crap, and it's looking this way. Time to go. Oh. Shh. Go to sleep. Go to sleep. Go to sleep. Little monster. All I want are these mushrooms down here. Well, it's time to go. Collect pumpkins to hasten health regeneration, like mana fungi, to hasten regeneration of mana. Am I the only one that hates the word mana, by the way? Harvest pumpkin. Or it's just a pumpkin and it said harvesting. I don't know what it is about the word mana, but it just... I don't like it. Turn the brightness down just a little bit. Whoa. You? It's a moon carrot. It's cool and all, but I want these. I want to go back and fight that thing, and I might do that after the video is done, which shouldn't be too much longer from now. Flame bite. Ancient crystal coin. How do we sort this mess? By type. Nope, that removes type as an option. There we go. Clutter, ingots, ingredients, keys. Weird, because I haven't actually used that yet. Did I miss where that could be used? Yes. Let's learn that, equip that magic. Right. Favorite this. Q. Ah. I see what happened there. Use traps to your advantage by defeating enemies with them. I assume stepping on that activates that blade. Done, troll. Oh. Hey there, buddy. I didn't mean to... You poor, stupid, stupid thing. I guess this guy saw the troll out there and was like, well, guess I'll die then. Troll fat. What the frick am I looking at here? Ooh, we'll take that. Vagrant gauntlets. No, you can keep that. Next level in 43 EP. I have no idea what that is. Things. Whoops. Pressing F puts you outside of your body. Staff of Flames, but it has an electrical symbol next to it. Yep. It fires a gout of flat fire that does 5 points of fire damage per second. Targets on fire take extra damage. Spell Tome Boon, rank 1. Let's keep that. The old sword as well. Restore stamina. Damage stamina discovered. Oh. So it... Okay. Unfortunate. Potion of stamina. It's rancid, but still better than nothing. Weird. I could have sworn I just... Oh, whatever. I don't think there's anything else here. Yeah, we're done. Let's try not to step on that. Wasn't there a door? Yes. Wild berries. Gotta make sure I'm safe to do this first. When you're hitting the E button in order to try and pick something and you're missing or there's just nothing there, it creates a sound that's like it almost... Thought I saw something down there. That could almost be construed as someone trying to sneak up on you. Alright. That sounds dangerous. Oh, I didn't know I was still crouching. Flames will keep that. Right click and the old sword on the left click. You okay, buddy? You need some help. I'm fully willing to help you. For 30 gold coins. Stamina low. Your stamina's low, power attacks and jumping drain your stamina. When you are walking instead of running, it regenerates faster. You can recover stamina with potions, not spotions, or spells. Are you okay? That's well done. Oh, this is the guy. Well, he's got a lot of stuff, so we're going to take all of it. His gauntlets are terrible. Give no armor. Shift. Put those on. Life absorption. Yes! We'll take the arrows. The brittle longbow. Doesn't really work with magic. But I will take it. Wait. Let's put these potions on favorites as well. Two. Three. That's what I wanted in his design or creation. So we can get down that way, but should we? Also, does this have anything? Yeah. Hard fights require tactic. Press M2 while blocking to execute a bashing attack. I don't know how to block. You skipped that part. And there's something over here. And it's scaring me. Oh, look at that. We quick saved. Bravery plus 50. But really, what the frick is that? Seize me. You've got this, and I think that, and something to my left, and this. We have at least 4 possible enemies to deal with. I don't think they can get to me where I am. So maybe this is the opportunity we need. We have a favorite bow, so we have to find it. But the old robe is lighter, so we'll keep that. Let's see how this works. We've made a terrible mistake, haven't we? Because they're coming right for us. And this with the sword. Yep. Okay, let's go. You okay, buddy? Tenderized. Wait, hold on. So the arcane fever isn't going anywhere. Ice Claw, we'll take that. Wait, it's about to exit combat. Give me that thistle. You've risen to level 2. You receive 5 learning points, 4 crafting points, and 1 memory point. Current attributes are health 90, mana 88, stamina 95. Choose an attribute you want to raise. Daddy could use some more health. I also like stamina. Pretty sure we're going to need that for later. I think we'll focus on health and stamina with a little mana. So let's see. Psionics allow its devotees to control the mind of their enemies. The higher your psionics, The less mana psionic spells cost, psionics is subject to the memories of the Sinistrope. Arcane Fever determines your mental health as a magic user. Casting healing spells using potions or being at specific locations raise the fever. When your fever increases, you first get Mali. Once it hits 100, Mali, I suppose. Once it hits 100%, you die. Okay. Let's go with that. Elementalism. I'm probably just squandering points at this point. We have that already. Okay, it increases weakness to magic. Why are we? Oh, there we go. Caps lock. Hold on. Caps lock changes whether you auto run or walk. Ooh, hey, this is the guy I shot. Sucks to be him. Wait. There were three of them. Thistle, anyone? I think it increases weakness to magic, though, so I don't really care about it, but I am an alchemist. Whatever I'm hearing is over in this area. Got that over there. And a fish. Can I shoot the fish? wonder if I can electrocute the water. Hello. Crab shell. Stamina recovery. Okay. I didn't see it, but apparently I caught it. What am I hearing? Leather boots, we'll take that. Now it sounds like it's coming from over there. Let's see. I should probably equip that or use that. I'm going to hoard the rest of my points until I know. Set a lantern. There we go. Can I do anything with it? Hey there, buddy. Buddies. No escape. Are you okay, man? Hey, let me help. You are not trying to run away. Missed. Okay. There are probably arrows in this river, but I can't see them, so I'm moving on. Oh, hey there. That's one arrow. Something off to my right. It's really obnoxious. Hey. Aren't the berries here? Weakness to magic. I mean, sure, why not? Restores health. Damages mana. Carp restores stamina. So eating random things isn't going to restore your health. So that's an animal right there, but I think it's domesticated. Where did the wild berries end up? Here. Filter them by name. Assort them by name, I mean. We have those boots. We did find boots, right? There they are. Oh. I mean, I would just walk up and kill this guy, but... Hey there, buddy. You're the ugliest little cute thing I've ever seen. Empty barrels. Answers marked with that carry the story forward, but there's a chance some dialogue options aren't available anymore. Oh, are we an alchemist too?
Now would you look at that? I knew I'd seen someone scrambling in the mountains. What brings you here, my sir?
Wondering why your hood doesn't fit on your head quite right.
Who am I? Findalires, Apothecarius by my path. Pleased to meet you. And you are at Suncoast, in the south of Enderal. Where are you from? But wait, don't tell me. I know that accent. Nerim, isn't it? I...
There we go. Everything's locked up. At least for the night we should.
Wait a second. Who's that?
Just an adventurer on his way. No reason to worry.
No reason to worry? For heck's sake, Finn. How do you know that this guy isn't with the bandits? You said you'd call me if anyone showed up. And now you're standing here, having a chat with him as if this were the bathing house of Ark.
Lo and behold, we are still alive. Now, is there anything else, Carbos?
Carbos!
I've got my eye on you. Touch any of our stuff, and you'll regret it.
If I touch any of your stuff, you won't know it.
May I present Carbos as he lives and breathes. Sorry about that just now. That's just how he is. In any case, if you don't need any more help, I'd suggest you move on. Follow the way east behind the dam house. It'll lead you to a village called Riverville. Ah, here, take this. Truth be told, you don't look so healthy. Your eyes. Ah, well, whatever.
What was that about my eyes?
Peculiar about you. I don't know how else to say it. I would examine you myself, but we don't have the right equipment with us. So if I were you, I'd ask a priest in Riverville to have a look at you. Who knows? Maybe you caught something in that temple.
Oh, I most certainly did. We got the ick. Let's see. Can you tell me more about this region?
Well, what can I tell you? This is the Sun Coast, in the south of Enderal. A pretty peaceful area, except for all the animals and bandits that have recently started going crazy. And, well, that's pretty much it. I think you should ask the people in Riverville if you want to know more. They certainly have some stories to tell.
I see. Are there places that might be of interest to someone like me?
To an adventurer? If you ask me, what you need before you adventure anywhere is some good old-fashioned shut-eye. But yes, there are some places. The Three River Watch, for example, right there below the Stone Arch. It was once an old trading post, but now it's full of shady characters. And there's also a big Pyrian ruin south of it.
Oh, ruins. You said you were an apothecarius by path. What do you mean?
By the Black Guardian. You really are an outlander, aren't you? My path is... Well, it's just me path. My role designated to me by Malthus. A kind of calling, if you will.
A role designated by Malthus? You mean the gods assign your professions to you?
Not exactly. Malthus designates our place in society. Generally the same one our fathers and forefathers occupied. I walk the path of the erudites, and there's also the manufacturers, the sublimes, and, of course, the pathless. Within these roles, we are free to choose a profession, but certain vocations that are available to an erudite are not permitted to a manufacturer, which is one path below.
Your life sucks.
However, below does not mean that it is in any way inferior. Everyone on Enderal does what they do best. And who would know better than the gods what exactly that is?
Aren't you frustrated by being bound to that path? Don't you want to, I don't know, advance?
In the folly of my youth, I might have thought about it, yes. But then I realized that half of what goes wrong in this world has to do with the desire to advance. I am interested in living the righteous path and to contribute to the preservation of my people. That's enough for me. And only the faithful will be granted the eternal paths upon death.
Speaking of paths, I remember we have one memory point to spend. Who are the pathless?
Men or women who have never received the path consecration, or those who have broken their path. Brigands, glimmer dust smugglers, murderers. Well, you know.
I have no idea how this is supposed to go, so...
Maybe. But if I look at other countries, even within the civilized world, it's hard to find a people as peaceful as ours.
I guess. Hey, give me some money for my junk.
Why not? Show me what you've got. Maybe I have some things you can use.
Buy or sell an item by selecting it and pressing E. Buying prices are higher than selling prices, obviously. Through the name selection at the bottom, you can switch between your inventory and the merchant's. The inventory of merchants gets refilled after a few days. There's so much junk. Book for blocking. I have no idea when I picked that up. Actually, these books sell for some obscene prices. I have this. Wait. Oh, that's him. Well. Get rid of that and that. I'm mostly just trying to filter out the clutter. Wait.
Yeah, why not? Show me what you've got. Maybe I have some things you can use.
I didn't want to get rid of my smoking pipe. I wanted to smoke later. We've got some pickaxes we can pawn off. Nothing of actual value. I'll hold on to that. Pretty much it. Yeah, we'll hold on to the rest.
Don't mention it. I wish you a quick recovery and safe roads. Walk blessed. Carbos, do we need the still tomorrow? Or can I clean all the tools?
Places, Finn, I'm playing. Don't bother me.
I guess that means no.
Why did my...
By the righteous path, what happened to you? You look as if you've met the Black Guardian himself.
I don't feel so good. I suddenly have this kind of fever. Do you have any idea what it could be?
Fever? Well, there could be many causes. Wait a moment. I think I still have some grunt root. That should be enough to ease your pain, at least for now. Take a seat at the fire. The warmth might help you.
Oh, so now we're brewing potions for complete strangers.
Well, if the strangers are about to die of fever, then yes. There was that oath we swore once, remember? To help the afflicted, to...
Whatever.
Thank you. Gruntroods, Gruntroods. Ah, here we go.
Don't feel so good. Mr. Stark?
So, let's see. Sheer cup, some water. Ha, done.
Done.
I can't make any promises,
shit.
But...
Finn, the still.
Do something, damn it! Do something! Oh, no. Oh, sod it!
Do I really have to watch every step you take? That was a fucking close call.
Hey, I'm sorry, alright. We'll pick up a new one in Ark.
You're paying for it. Here I thought this bloody day couldn't get any worse.
This day isn't getting any better. Here, drink this. It'll help you. See? You already look a lot better. Still, you should let a priest take a look at that fever as soon as possible. The grunt root potion will wane in a few days.
Thanks, but... What just happened there?
What? You mean the still? Bad quality. And too much heat, I'd wager. But, whatever will be, will be.
But the explosions, the voices, they were yours.
Explosion? I'm not sure I'll follow.
Oh, that'd be great, wouldn't it? Finn Dalaris died in 8234. Cause of death, exploding still.
Ha ha. Look, I really don't know what you're talking about. Maybe...
Wait a second. What was that?
I can't get up.
I could have sworn I saw something moving over there.
Oh, shit!
Yep.
Cabos!
They've hit me, Finn. Those bastards... Hit me.
Cabos, I... Do something, damn it! Do something!
My goodness! They said screw Cabos, but screw Finn in particular.
Mysterious survivor has awoken.
What? Who are you?
Jaspar Matumiel Delveric. Jaspar for short. And you, my friend, are at my very own campsite. Before you ask, yes, the bandits killed both of the apothecary.
Did you manage to pick their pockets?
The only reason you're still alive is that the impact of the explosion threw you right into the thicket. Most of your injuries are only superficial, but your fever, well, that's a different story.
Wait, how do you know about my fever? You didn't go sticking your finger in places it didn't belong, did you?
Quite a lot, actually. You're suffering from Arcanist's fever. Honestly, I'm surprised the old apothecarius didn't see that. Let me guess, you're suddenly capable of doing things you previously knew only from the bard songs, right?
I don't know what that means.
You're unusually strong, you have reflexes like a cat, and drinking potions or any kind of magically infused substance leaves a bitter afterglow in your head.
I don't know what that means.
Well then, congratulations. Your magical talent just blossomed. A bit late, given your age, but it happens.
Who are you calling old?
Simply, the fever is a result of your body not being able to cope with it. It's not much of a problem for now, but if you don't let an Arcanist treat you sometime soon, things are going to get grim.
So an Arcanist will be able to cure this, then?
Contain it, not cure it. From here on out, you're always going to be a little more sensitive than someone without magical gifts. tolerable compared to what your magic will allow you to do.
What do you mean by a little sensitive? You aren't trying to proposition me to stick your finger in places it doesn't belong.
Prone to certain conditions? As I said, your fever will get worse if you drink healing potions. But you'll also be a lot more susceptible to nightmares and those kinds of things. Also, you should be very cautious of areas with magical contamination, such as Thalgard in the east.
If I contain the fever, but I let it get worse, what happens then?
At first, diffuse headaches, general unease. Later on, your eyesight will blur, your limbs will grow weak, and you'll get a maddening itch all over your body. If you leave it untreated for too long, you'll either die or turn into an orbaya.
Tell me more about what an orbaya is.
Yes, it can kill you. Everything has its price, as the wise hermit likes to say. And an orbaya is basically a giant undead version of yourself with tumors and pus all over your body. Just never let the fever get too bad.
So are there any other remedies, or...?
Well, there's ambrosia, but for an uncontained fever, it will only postpone the symptoms. Later, you can drink it whenever the fever gets worse. The stuff looks and tastes like undead sweat, and is bloody expensive, but it's the only thing that really helps.
Hmm. And what about these visions? Are they also caused by the fever?
You have visions?
No. Forget I said anything. I don't know. You know what? If it becomes a problem, we'll just set him on fire.
Not that I know of. The only visions I've ever had are those that come along with a good pipe of peaceweed. You know what? As I said, someone needs to contain your fever as soon as possible. And as it happens, I know people. But in return, I want you to tell me everything. What did you do in that temple? And what's the story with those visions? I can't put my finger on it, but there's something strange about you.
See, there goes that finger again. Treatment for information. All right.
Well, then, the stage is yours. I see. My condolences for your loss. So, let me summarize. You somehow survived getting thrown into the open sea. And while you were half dead, had this dream in which you saw burnt bodies and a blinding light?
Yeah, but it wasn't just a dream. It was more like a memory. The temple I saw it in was the same as the one in the valley.
And you also said that your magic didn't develop gradually, as it usually does, but all at once, right?
Right after I washed up on the shore, yeah. With these visions, of course.
Well, that's quite the story. I guess you know how absurd it sounds, but for some reason, I believe you.
Well, I could shoot you with fire.
In my life, and you aren't one of them. All right, it's settled then. I'll introduce you to my employer and ask him to treat you. Before we leave, however, there's something else I need to take care of, and I could use a hand. The sooner we get that done, the sooner we can make for Ark.
Tell me it's to clear out those bandits that killed those two apothecary. Carai. Not sure which option is better, but... Well, technically, there's only one option. Alright, I'll help you.
Splendid. You'll need some information before you can help me, though. I take it the fact that Vin has seen better times hasn't eluded your attention, has it? For the last 2 years, there have been wars and unrest everywhere. And even though in Enderal there's officially peace, there are peculiar things happening here, too. Normally docile animals and batiers attacking wanderers in the open. The dead awakening in hordes. It's unsettling, to say the least.
I could imagine.
The strangest thing, however, is the red madness.
Do you think this chaos could be related to the rumors about the Lightborn's death?
Yeah, the rumors. I've heard them too. and I could indeed imagine that they're true, and that there's a connection, yes.
Then you actually believe someone killed the gods, the Lightborn?
As I said, maybe. If you ask me, the Lightborn were never more than imposters anyway. False gods.
And here I thought the Enderalians were the most pious people in the civilized world.
Oh, I'm hardly representative. I've seen that a long life is only one of the things powerful magic can achieve. And the false deity theory isn't that new, after all, is it? Seriously, say the Lightborn really are as mighty as the revelations say they are. Wouldn't they have the power to call down lightning on me right here and right now to punish me for my insolence? No. The Lightborn were immortal kings, and that's all. At least, that's how I see it. I hope I didn't hurt your feelings.
Of course not.
Splendid. You never know. But we digress.
Right. You mentioned something about red madness?
Yeah. It's some kind of mental illness that makes people lose their mind. Just a couple of weeks ago, there was a smith in Ark who butchered his entire family. He was drunk. That doesn't explain why he screamed things like "Fear the light" while he was doing it. Or a young woman of noble path who set her own house on fire while her family was asleep. Now, you might say that these kinds of things happen, but by now there have been more than a dozen incidents in a very short period of time. The fact that the afflicted's eyes glow red while they go rampant has made people call the disease red madness. Thing is, some weeks ago it happened again, only this time it was a magister from the Holy Order itself.
Magister.
A teacher who instructs the novices aspiring to become keepers. His name was YEArEuS, a man with more than 60 winners on his back.
What happens?
Well, according to the sole survivor, he entered the teaching room that day as usual, but instead of giving his lecture on alchemy, he gave a strange kind of speech where he kept going on about how mankind is corrupted and that it has succumbed to the void. Then his eyes started glowing, he locked the door and blew himself up in a magical explosion.
So what's your role in all this? You said you work for the Order, but I don't take it you're a monk.
I'm not one for vows and austerity, so no, I'm no keeper. My specialty is recovering lost things. Treasures, tomes, memories, and the like. And the Order hired me to do just that. They want to know how a man like YEArEuS could fall victim to the Red Madness. And thus, if there's something like a pattern to this malady.
So you're after his motives, but how am I supposed to help you with that? I don't know anything about him.
Doesn't matter. YEArEuS grew up in a small village not far from here. And according to the Order, he visited it quite often after his partner died. What I want your help with is finding clues as to why he did what he did. What do you think?
I guess so.
Great. First of all, I want you to travel to Riverville and talk to an old man named Alfred, a childhood friend of YEArEuS. Ask him what he makes of the incident and whether he has any explanation for it. Secondly, a farm boy told me that he saw YEArEuS throw something into the sea during his last visit there. The winds have been blowing inland the last couple of days, so go search the shoreline and see if it washed up. I myself will take a look at the house YEArEuS grew up in. Ah, and here. This is a map of the region. YEArEuS's house is at the blue dot. So, unless there's anything else, I'd say let's step to it. Just meet me at the farm when you're done.
If a quest objective is marked by one or more stars, they indicate the difficulty of said quest, and at the same time, the level you should have for the quest. 1, very easy. 2, easy. 3, medium. 4, be careful. And so, with this information in our heads and fear at our back, we end this video, but not before we promise to bring you more, whether you want it or not.
Good pipe.
Whether you wanted it or not, there will be more. and I hope you guys are looking forward to it, because I'm enjoying myself. And knowing Skyrim, I'm going to be getting into a lot of trouble. But not before we get this fever dealt with. I don't want to die to that. So, with all that said, we will see you.
Never walk back on the road from the aged man's abode.
Ugh, blazes. Sorry. I know. I can't sing.
Next time.